The 11 disciples went to Galilee to the mountain to which Jesus had ordered them. When they saw him, they worshiped, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached and said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always until the end of the age." The Gospel of the Lord. Today we celebrate the solemnity of the Most Holy Trinity, but before we explore that, I want to mention that today we do celebrate a First Communion, and that is Alex Sejas. So Alex will be one with us at the table of the Lord today, and he is surrounded in love by his parents and family and friends. So Alex, it's wonderful to have you with us at the table. Where does one begin with the Holy Trinity? And oftentimes people will say, when it comes to trying to explain the Holy Trinity, that it is simply a mystery and that we'll never really understand it, therefore, let's just move on. Well, yes, we may never understand the Holy Trinity, but that doesn't mean that we don't talk about it. That doesn't mean that we don't explore it. That doesn't mean that we don't ponder it. There are many angles that we can take a look at around the Trinity, and our sacred scripture today provides us several glimpses into, shall we say, the reality of the Holy Trinity. So though we may never completely understand it or grasp it, nonetheless, we are called to explore and ponder. We are called to have conversation, perhaps debate even, around the Holy Trinity, to talk about it. So today we celebrate this mystery of faith. But so is the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary is a mystery of faith. At every liturgy, the priest says, the mystery of faith. So mystery does not mean that we keep it at a distance, but rather mystery is an invitation for us to draw closer to it. I think of mystery in terms of the universe. Do we fully comprehend the universe? Absolutely not. But that doesn't mean that we don't talk about it and try to break it open and unpack it and try to explain it to the best of our ability. And one of the things that I'll say about the Holy Trinity is the Holy Trinity is about relationship. Well, those of you who are married, do you really comprehend and understand fully and completely your spouse? Isn't your spouse somewhat, after many years of marriage, still a mystery? Still someone that you're pondering? You know, my parents are 67 years married, and from time to time, my father will say to me, "I never knew, after all these years, your mother felt that way." Never. You know, I never knew that she even thought this way. You know, so even on a human level, and in many ways, we don't don't really fully understand the person whom we love. And individually, I'm still trying to figure out who I am. You know, there are things that come up in my heart and in my emotional realm and world, and there are things that come up in my thinking process that, wow, that when they do appear and catch me unaware, sometimes I go, I didn't even know, had no idea, didn't even have a clue, that even thought that way or felt that way. And so even I, as we explore our own lives, you know, ourselves, we remain a mystery. But nonetheless, it's really an invitation to explore. So in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, everything begins and ends with God. Every time we make the sign of the cross, it says who we are and whose we are. And we take, we bless people with the sign of the cross. We bless objects with the sign of the cross. We bring people to the Trinity. And so there are a few angles from our readings today. The first, I love the first reading. The first reading from the book of Deuteronomy. And if you really look at it, it's an incredible reading. A number of years ago, when I celebrated my 25th anniversary as a priest, on priest retreat, I had the honor to preach to my brother priests. And I was given the opportunity to select a first reading. And the reading that I selected was the one that we just heard from the book of Deuteronomy. I mean, think about this. Ask now of the days of old, before your time, ever since God created man upon the earth. Ask from one end of the sky to the other, did anything so great ever happen before? Of course not. But God is first mentioned in his act of creation. Was it ever heard of? Of course not. Did a people ever hear the voice of God speaking from the midst of fire as you did and live? Of course not. So Moses reminds the people of the great care God has shown his people. That is what Moses is reminding his people of. God's great care for his people. That he has chosen his people. That he has set them free from slavery. And is bringing them into a new land. And so the very first thing that I would say about the Blessed Trinity is that God, our Father, is revealed to us in our first reading as a God who cares for us, his people. Though invisible, he cares for us, and he accompanies us and journeys with us. Our God cares. And, you know, in prayer this week, I approached the Lord, and I said, God, our Father, what do you want me to say to your people here on Sunday, on this weekend? This people whom you love, what do you want me to say to them? And this is what I heard in prayer. And this is what God says to you through me. Give them my best. Give them my best. And so God our Father gives you his best. And to me, that's what came out of our very first reading today. From the book of Deuteronomy, that God cares deeply for us. And then in our second reading today, one of my favorite readings from St. Paul is this. I mean, this care is, shall we say, even further extended. Because St. Paul says, but you received a spirit of adoption through whom we cry, Abba. Abba, Father. An Aramaic word that means dad. And oftentimes we have have an affectionate name for our Father. It might be Dad, it might be Pops, it might be Papa. But this Aramaic word, Abba, is a very informal word. It is a word of affection. And so with that, God cares so much for us that we have received his Spirit, and that Spirit cries out, Abba, Father. And it was Jesus who taught us the Lord's Prayer, Our Father, Father, God, our Father. Now, sometimes people will say, well, Father Tim, what do? In the classroom of silence? You've been inviting us several times to go to the classroom of silence and to spend 10 minutes a day in the classroom of silence. So the classroom of silence means you find your favorite place. It might be a room in the house, your favorite window where you can look out. You know your favorite place, something that is easily accessible. And what you do is what I did today for 15 minutes. And what you do is you sit up straight in the classroom of silence, eliminate all possible noise, if that's even possible. Shut the door, sit up straight, place your hands on your legs, and just begin to breathe. And as you exhale, say, Abba. 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 Just say that for 15 minutes. And just focus on that. Any distractions, just push them out. And just focus on the name Abba, Father. The creator of the universe, our God, has given us his Spirit that cries out, Abba. Father implies relationship. And so, Alex, today you are receiving Jesus. You're receiving our God who loves all of us, who gives us his best and feeds us with his son, Jesus. How blessed you are, how blessed we are. But that's all you need to do for the classroom of silence is take home your worship aid. And we invite you to take home the worship aid. We make plenty because we want you to take home the worship aid. Those are the readings for the week. And reflect on the readings. And is there a word, Abba? The spirit of adoption. I mean, look at our second reading today. You know, we're adopted, but we're not second class because we're adopted. Not at all. But rather, because St. Paul shows the adoption does not imply a second class birthright. But we are full heirs of God and joint heirs with God. Joint heirs with Christ. Heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. How blessed we are. Because Holy Trinity is all about love. It's about relationship. It's about the love and the beloved. The Father, the Son. And that outpouring of love is that energy. And that energy, say two simple things from our gospel reading today. By the way, the gospel reading today is the Great Commission, which means go. Jesus began his ministry in Galilee, and now the church is gathered in Galilee before Jesus returns to the Father. And so Galilee is where it all fans out. Go to all the nations of the world and baptize them in the name of the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit. But what I like about the gospel reading today is it said this. They worshiped, but they doubted. They worshiped, but they doubted. How could they possibly doubt? They worshiped, but they doubted. It says how human the apostles are. But I think it had their doubt had nothing to do with the Lord. I think their doubt had to do that they didn't quite believe in themselves. as to whether they could do the very same things that Jesus himself did. How could they possibly doubt as we look at the readings today? They have received the Spirit of adoption, the Spirit that cries out, Abba, the Father who cares for them and loves them. You know, let go of your doubt. You have been empowered. Empowered. And so are we, that we have. There's no reason for us to doubt ourselves. There's no reason for that, because we have the Spirit. We have the love of God. We have the fact that he cares for us so deeply. And then the final thing is simply this. He says, I am with you always. I am with you always until the end of the age. So just as our first reading, Moses assures them of God's presence, Jesus assures his church of his presence. Though invisible, he assures us of his presence. Visible in the sacrament. Especially in the Eucharist. So today, we honor our God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Everything begins and ends with God. And every time we make the sign of the cross, it says who we are.